Careblazer, what if I told you that there is a vitamin that could slow down Alzheimer's disease? The thing is, people with Alzheimer's already have this vitamin in their brain, but their body doesn't absorb it. So there is a vitamin that helps our body absorb it. Now I'm going to give you all the details, and I'm also going to link this vitamin in the description below, as well as the studies that I am talking about that I'm referencing that show this could be a potential help. However, as always, before you take anything new, please contact your healthcare provider. I am not your healthcare provider. I am not a prescriber. I am just giving educational information here on YouTube, but I do think that this is pretty exciting. I do happen to know several healthcare professionals and neurologists who are taking this supplement. I don't want to keep it from you, but I want to make sure we do this in a very safe, healthy way. Careblazer, we already know that thiamine, vitamin B1, is super important for the brain to function properly. When we don't have good levels of B1 in the brain, things can go really well. You can kind of think about it like gas in a car. If there's no gas in the car, it's really not going to go. It's not going to do what it could do. That's the same if we think about vitamin B1 in the brain. Your brain's gonna stutter, struggle, slow down. So there is a supplement called benfotiamine. It is a supercharged synthetic type of B1. And the wild part is the majority of people with Alzheimer's disease have an adequate amount of vitamin B1, but their brains cannot absorb it. So what benfotiamine does is it actually helps the brain absorb B1. Benfotiamine helps it get into the brain easier. It actually helps to keep nerve cells healthy too. As I was doing my research, it sounds like this type of vitamin is better known for help with diabetes. Again, please talk to your healthcare provider about all this. But exciting new research in 2020 and 2021 showing that this actually could be really helpful for people with dementia as well. So here's one study I'll share with you. Scientists took a look at 70 people and gave half of the group benfotiamine every single day, and the other half of the group took a placebo, which is a sugar pill, meaning it's not really supposed to do anything, but the person taking it doesn't know. They don't know whether they're getting the actual supplement or whether they're getting a sugar pill. They're just told to take this every day. Then they looked at these people 1 year later, and the group that took the benfotiamine, their memory improved big time. Oh, and I should back up. The 70 people that they included in this study, these were people with early Alzheimer's disease or mild severity Alzheimer's disease. So after a year, these people with Alzheimer's disease, their memory significantly improved. The benfotiamine group had 43% less cognitive decline than the group who was given the placebo, the group who didn't take that supplement. 43% less. They found that the group that took the supplement were able to hang on to their thinking skills longer. So it's not curing the disease. We do not have anything like that. But this is suggesting that it could slow down the disease. Now, before we get too excited, this is a study of 70 people. Yes, it was a randomized controlled placebo study, which is great, but it's a small study. We need to do this with bigger participants. And there is one happening right now with over 400 people, so I am excited to see those results. There's also another study happening looking at how the supplement might work in minority groups to make sure it's working the same for everybody. So you might be thinking, should I start giving benfotiamine to my loved one? Should I start taking benfotiamine? Those are pretty good questions that I would be asking myself as well. That's a great conversation to have with your healthcare provider. Here's what I will say. I'm very hopeful. I'm very hopeful about this early research study. I'm hopeful about the ones that are ongoing. It's pretty exciting. This might actually be something that can slow down the disease, and not only slow down the disease like pathologically, meaning maybe they'll see benefits in the brain, who knows, but most importantly, slowing it down clinically, meaning their thinking declines actually slow down. Like, that's amazing. What do you think about this research? And would you consider giving benfotiamine to you or your loved one? I'm very curious on your thoughts. You can leave them in the comment below. Have any of you tried it, taken it? Any of you currently using it? Let us know what your thoughts are on this, and maybe you already are aware of it. Also, Careblazer, if this was interesting to you, if any of my videos have been helpful to you, I want you to know something pretty amazing, and that is we have a Dementia Dose newsletter. It goes out every Thursday, and it's my goal that this is the most helpful dementia care newsletter that exists. We put cutting edge information, new research, tips on caregiving, support, inspiration. I include links to free downloads from time to time. I'm really trying to make it the best resource possible. It's entirely free. All you have to do is go to careblazers.com/dementia dose to sign up and you'll start receiving those emails. All right, I'm sending you so much love. I hope this video was helpful. Bye.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says, thank you very much.